Hello, a very good morning to all. Myself, Khushbu Balodia, Assistant Professor, Chemical Engineering Department, LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. My subject is Green Technology and Sustainable Development. So this is the third lecture regarding this subject. In a previous lecture of this subject, we have gone through the concept of green technology and green chemistry along with the what are the needs of green chemistry. Now in a today's lecture, we will cover the 12 principle of green chemistry. So the 12 principle of green chemistries are like this. One says prevention, second principle atom economy, third one less hazardous chemical synthesis, designing safer chemicals, safer solvents and auxiliary substance, design for energy efficiency, use of renewable raw material and feedstocks, reduced intermediate derivatives, catalyst and catalytic reagent, design product which degraded easily, real-time analysis and inherently safer chemistry. So these all are the 12 principles of green chemistry. We will see each and every principle with detail and with the example. So first principle says there's the waste prevention. So it is better to prevent waste formation than to treat it after it is formed. After the waste is generated, we need to think about the treatment of the waste and we need to think about the also storage and transportation of waste. So rather to that, think of the waste reduction at the source itself, at the formation stage itself, reduce the waste generation. So it is better to prevent the waste formation than to treat after it is formed. So waste requires the expense of capital, energy and resources with ideally no benefit. By preventing waste generation, the risk associated with the storage, handling, transportation and treatment that can be limited, right? So this can be explained by one example. So in that example is pulp and paper industry. So in pulp and paper industry, earlier days there was a chlorine compounds were used, right? But we can say that chlorine compound or chlorinated compounds highly toxic in nature and it generates some chlorinated wastewater. So we need to think about the treatment of that waste. Also we need to think about that chlorinated product. So rather than to use that chlorinated compound as a bleaching agent in pulp and paper industry, one can use another component or another substance as a bleaching agent. So what we can do in a greener approach or in a greener technology, that green chemistry developed a method that convert the pulp into paper using polyoxalomethylate salts, or I can say using H2O2 as a bleaching agent, and by this way only water and carbon dioxide is generated as a byproduct. So here we are reducing the waste formation at the source itself, right? In earlier what happened in conventional process of pulp and paper industry, some chlorine compounds were used as a bleaching agent. So as a result, some chlorinated compounds are generated in a wastewater, right? So what we can do to alter this system? We can use some another bleaching agent, right? And that bleaching agent, here we are using, that is polyoxalomethylate salts, and as a result we can get only water and carbon dioxide as a byproduct. So first principle says that prevent the waste at the source itself, right? Because this will reduce the waste generation, risk associated with the waste storage, and also reduce the cost in transportation and treatment, right? Another principle, second principle of green chemistry says that the atom economy. Atom economy, that means synthetic method should be designed to maximize the incorporation of all materials used in the process into final product. Atom economy, that means how much your process is efficient, or I can say if all the reactant is get converted into your targeted product or useful product or not. So this is regarding that, Right, so develop a process or methods in a such a way that most of your materials, right, get used in the final product. So this eliminate the need of recycling the byproduct. Sometimes what happened, right, if your desired product is not forming, so along with that some byproducts are formed. So you need to think about the byproduct, or you need to recycle that byproduct into your system. So if you increase your atom economy, so it will eliminate the need of recycling of the byproduct. So atom economy is an important concept in a green chemistry philosophy, and one of the most widely used matrices is for the measuring the how process is your greenness. Right, so if you want to measure your process in terms of greenness, so this is also one of the matrices one can use. So example, I can say that this reaction that is happening, if we'll calculate the atom economy of this reaction, that means equation says that percentage of atom economy is equal to number of atoms incorporated divided by number of atoms in the reactant multiply by 100. So if we'll calculate percentage atom economy of this reaction, that means molecular weight of your desired product, that means divided by molecular weight of all reactant multiply by 100. So this will lead to the percentage atom economy of 50%. By this example, we can clearly say that there is a yield is 100%, right? But that yield does not lead towards the desired product. In this, yield is even if 100%, only half of the mass of reactant are incorporated to produce desired product, while half of the reactant are wasted in my unwanted byproducts. Right? So you can see that try to increase that percentage. That means increase the atom economy so that most of your reactant that converted into your desired product. Third principle of green chemistry says that less hazardous chemical synthesis. Whenever practicable, synthetic method should be designed to use and generate substance that poses little or no toxicity to people. Here whenever practicable, that word is important because always it is not in our hand to use the less toxic material or non-hazardous material in our process, right? But try to reduce those whenever it is possible. Less toxic material means lower hazard to worker in industry and also research laboratory, and it will lower down the pollution load on our environment. This principle focus on selecting reagent that having the lower risk and generate only environmental friendly byproduct. So example here I can give that in the manufacturing of polystyrene foam sheet packing material, chlorofluorocarbons were used, and chlorofluorocarbons we all know that contribute to the ozone depletion, right? So there will be a degradation of ozone take place. So because of that, global warming and ground level smog that is also increasing. So what we can do? We can replace those chlorofluorocarbon with carbon dioxide, right? So we can get a promising reagent, we can get promising result that that can be replaced by carbon dioxide. So that is also a good example that we are replacing our pollution generated substance, or we are replacing our toxic substance with non-toxic or with less harmful substance, right? Another principle four says designing safer chemicals. This leads to the product should be designed to affect the desired function while minimizing their toxicity. That says that design the chemical which is safer, right? So new product that should be designed that should in a such a way that it is inherently safer, it should be safer. So we can say this by a case study. A case study says that antifoltan, that is also known as a marine pesticide. Now what is the use of this marine pesticides, right? There is a attachment and there is a growth of marine organism in on the surface of our boat or on the surface of hull. So to prevent the attachment and growth of marine organisms, the hulls of ships are usually treated with the chemical components. So what we can done, what we can do for that on the outer surface of hull, a paint is applied, right? So along with the paint, some marine pesticide, or I can say antifoultants, are dispersed and it is applied on the hull. So what are the effect of this? In earlier days, what was used is in this TBTO is used. TBTO, that means tibutaldehyde oxide. So which is very dangerous to environment, or which is very dangerous to our aquatic life, our animals, right? So what was happened? TBTO, that is gradually leaching from the surface of hull and killing the fouling organisms in the surrounding area. That means our aquatic life get disturbed, right? This was we are doing to control the growth of attachment, right? To control that. But what was happening of because of that? That it is increasing our marine animal. So these compounds were chronically toxic to marine life, and it also can enter into food chain, which is also a bioaccumulative. That means this substance, but particularly TBTO, is not non-biodegradable, right? So also its half-life is higher. So it is not easily degraded, and it lives longer period of time in the environment. So what we can do to alternate this, and also along with that we can achieve our goal also, right? So one company developed, that is Roman and Haas company developed C9 chemical. So instead of TBTO, one can use this component along with the paint, and along with this we can control the damage of our sieve. So ultimately the goal of green chemistry, or the 12 principles, says that meet your requirement. Generate the product also to meet your requirement, but that generation of your product should be such that there is a no harmful impact on the others, or there is a less harmful impact on the environment. So this was regarding the today's session of 12 principles.